Hey everyone, how's it going? In this video, let's have a look at the DotOS version 5.2.1. And this is an Android 11 version ROM. And I thought I would make some videos on Android 11 ROMs because Android 12 is already out, but some people may prefer to use Android 11. Hence, I'm making this video. And this is a pretty old ROM relatively. I'll be leaving the download links down in the description below. So let's have a look at the settings here. First of all, you have a few gesture options to quickly open the camera, and you have some gesture navigation customization options that you can see here. Here you can set the dead zone basically, which comes in pretty handy if you are annoyed that these gestures are triggered even when you don't want them to. And you have some power menu options as you can see here. Let's go back. And here you have certain suggestions here, which I choose to ignore. You have customization options as you can see here. As you can see here, there are countless options. You can even change the launcher grid and that kind of stuff. So there are a lot of options here. You have some icon pack options. You can basically change stuff here. And let's go, you have display notification transparency, and as you can see here, you have several options. You can enable the always on display, edge lighting, and change up the screen of animation. So at first glance, it may seem like there are not many options, but if you go and dig in deeper, there are a lot of options in this particular ROM. They have been neatly tucked away. And here you have quick setting options. As you can see here, you can customize the number of rows and columns, and you can also have your data usage enabled. Let's go in further. You have a few button options, as you can see here, to control the playback. Here are maintainers, but that's irrelevant for this particular video, I guess. And you even have an app lock option. So basically, if you have set a lock screen, you can use this to lock certain apps, and this would come in handy to hide your homework apps, if you know what I mean. And apart from that, you have a gaming dashboard. Here you can enable the gaming mode, and you have quick controls. So it basically shows a floating pill when you are in a game to have quickly take a screenshot or something like that, D&D. And as you can see here, you can block all the notifications when the gaming mode is on so you do not get disturbed. And you can add a game or they are automatically detected. And you can disable automatic brightness because your hand moves over the sensor atop while gaming. And it could change. Oh, brightness level at 69%. Nice. You have some nightlight options to turn on automatically via schedule. And these are quite generic options if you note here. And apart from that, the fluidity of this ROM has been pretty great. And if you are looking for an Android 11 ROM, this would definitely be one of my top choices because it has very few bugs, and only the general bugs like no VoLTE or view overfair that will be linked down in the description below. And you can find the link there. You will have the general overview of bugs that are present on all ROMs. I did not find any extra bug that was present on this ROM, and overall I really like this particular ROM. You have some home screen settings. As you can see here, you can hide the apps from drawer, and here you have screenshot, clear all, and share options. And this ROM has basically taken some, let's say, feedback or inspiration from Android 12 ROMs, so you may hit all of that. And under the accessibility options, you'll find it tucked away. Okay. You have some high contrast mode, advanced shortcuts from lock screen. That the main thing is the vibration and haptic intensity here. You can change that here. So it's hidden away here. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such reviews. And do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below in case you want me to cover something else about this particular ROM or other ROMs, I would be happy to read your comments and make future videos based on that. Bye-bye.